Hello everyone, good day to all. I welcome all of you for today's online live classes. I am Pushpa Shri, faculty of Bhattangbhatt Tutorials, and we are handling mathematics for you. So, well, my dear kids, in the last session, we have discussed about the the particular chapter, that is linear equations on one variable. And in today's session, let us continue the chapter. And in the last session, we have discussed a first part, that is the exercise part of first. And in today's session, let us continue the second exercise, that is exercise 4.2. And if you people have missed the first exercise, that is exercise 4.1, please go through the link or the description box and watch the previous class video. And well, we'll start up with today's class. We'll start with exercise 4.2. So your exercise 4.2 will start from today. So listen for the class, the very important class. Okay. So the first problem for today, if you subtract, the question is like this. If you subtract 1 by 2 from a, if you subtract 1 by 2 from a number and multiply the result by 1 by 2, comma, you get 1 by 8, full stop. What is the number? This is what they're asking over here. See to the question once, understand, and then move on to the solution. They're telling, if you subtract 1 by 2 from a number, there is one number, and from that number, if you subtract 1 by 2, and whatever the answer that you are going to get, with that, if you multiply the result of 1 by 2, so with that answer, if you multiply again 1 by 2, so you will get 1 by 8. Then that means which is that number they are asking. Okay. So we'll see to the solution. So since we don't know the number, so let the number be x. So according to question, what they are telling? So a number, if you subtract 1 by 2 from a number, so we have to subtract 1 by 2 from a number, and since we don't know the number, we named it as x. And if you multiply the result by 1 by 2, so again you will get one result. If you multiply that result with 1 by 2, then it will be equal to 1 by 8. Then what is that number? You have to find out. For that, you have to simplify the equation. So x by 2 will make it as an equalize. Minus 1 by 4. How you will get 1 by 4? 2 into 2, it is 4. Here we are making the denominator same, which is equal to 1 by 8. So x by 2 is equal to 1 by 8 plus 1 by 4. And x by 2 is equal to 8. Because 8 plus 4, if you take the LCM, see here, 4 2s are 4 1s are 2 1s are 4 2s are it is 8. And now take the first part, that is 1 by 8 into 4, sorry 8. 8 1s are 8 1s are. So 1 1s are it is 1 plus 1 by 4 if you take now. 1 by 4 into 8, 4 1s are 4 2s are. 2 1s are it is 2. So how much you have got now? So you have got 3, right? Here. So x, I'll be continuing here. X by 2 is equal to 3 by 8. And now further you can do, that is x is equal to 3 by 8 into 2. 2 1s are 2, 4s are 8. So therefore x is equal to 3 by 4. Hope you have got this. Copy down this now. Fine, hope you have copied this. I'll move on to the second problem. You can listen for the second problem now. The second problem is like this. The perimeter of a rectangular swimming pool. The perimeter of a rectangular swimming pool. The perimeter of a rectangular swimming pool is 154 meter, full stop and continue. Its length is 2 meter more than twice its breadth. Full stop. What are the lengths and breadths of the pool? Breadth of the pool. So this is your question. So understand the question as it is first. The perimeter of a rectangular swimming pool. There is one rectangular swimming pool. The perimeter, that means the area, the surface area of that is 154 meter. The whole rectangular swimming pool perimeter is 154, and the length of that is 2 meter, more than twice its breadth. So whatever the breadth is there, from that breadth, the length is twice as that. Okay. And what are the length and breadth? That means what is the length, what is the breadth? They are not telling it directly. Indirectly, they are asking the length as well as the breadth. So we'll see to the solution now. Perimeter of a rectangular pool. So perimeter of a rectangular pool. That is how much? 154 meter. And the breadth we don't know. Let it be x. That is breadth of the rectangular. Bx. Okay. So next, coming to the third one. That is length. They are telling it is a length of the rectangle, they are telling that is 2 times of length plus breadth. Okay. So the next. So what we have to do? 2 times of length 2x plus 2 plus x, which is equal to 154 meter. That means the length plus breadth of 2 times will be equal to the total perimeter of the pool. So now 2 plus 1, it is 3x plus 2, which is equal to 154 meter. 3x plus 2 is there, no? So as it is, I'll take, which is equal to 154 by 2. So 3x is equal to 77 minus 2. So I'll be continuing here. 3x is equal to 75. X is equal to 75 by 3. So x is equal to 25 meter. So now we got to know the x. So that is, x is the breadth we got to know. Then what is the length? Twice of that, right? So breadth, therefore, b, I'll just write it in short form. B is 25. That is x, and the length, that is 2x plus 2, that is 2 into 25 plus 2, that is 50 plus 2, which is 52 centimeter. Don't forget to write centimeter or meter, it's actually meter. Okay, complete this, and as soon as people complete, just tell me. Fine, hope you have completed this. Now I'll move on to the third problem. The third problem is like this. Sum of two numbers is sum of two numbers is 95 full stop and continue if one exceeds the other by by 15 full stops and continue find the number what they are telling in the question the sum of two numbers that means if you add two numbers the sum will be 95 and one number is exceeding the other number by 15 then what is the number you have to find so let the number be x here also since we don't know the number so let the number be x and then other number will become other number will be where the other number will be exceeding the first number by 15 right so x plus 15 so now x plus 15 which will be equal to how much they are telling it is 95 so x plus x 2x plus 15 which is equal to 95 and 2x is equal to 95 less 15 and 2x is equal to 80 so I'll be continuing here x is equal to 80 by 2 okay so x is equal to 40 so therefore the first number is 40 and the second number they are telling that it is exceeding by 15 so 40 plus 15 it is 55 take down this now question number 3 fine hope you have completed this now I'll go with the next problem problem number 4 so we'll see to the next problem that is problem number 4 see to the question now two numbers are in the ratio five is to three full stop and continue if they differ by 18 if they differ by 18 what are the numbers what they are asking in the question there are two numbers the numbers are in the ratio of 5:3 and numbers and if they differ by 18 that means the total of that is 18 what are the numbers they are asking so let the two numbers be 5x and 3x okay next 5x minus 3x because they are going to differ right which is 18 so 2x is equal to 18 x is equal to 18 by 2 x is equal to 9 so now you have got to know x is 9 therefore numbers are so instead of 5x 5 into 9 that is 45 and the next is 3x that is 3 into 9 27 so 45 and 27 are the answers copy down this now